A freelance photographer working in art, humanitarian education and research projects in the fields of photography, video, graphic prints, etc. First of all, I want to thank to both juries in Transition Russia International Festival jury and the In Transition International Conference jury to select my photo projects to be shown at the traveling exhibition, as well as here to have opportunity to advocate my work in the example of the field practice here before this audience as well. I take both names of events very seriously and literally, and would like to share my working experience with and for refugees with you. After any military intervention, refugees usually first live in tents, then are moved to the desolated houses situated in the suburbs of the cities. Sometimes they get a big room, but without a window, no drainage system is functioning properly, without electricity to use the technical devices. And by it, they are keeping the old productive system alive. Anyway, for people in need, sorry, this is the only way to survive. All these are everyday companions of every refugee existence all around the globe. All of the refugees believe that such a situation did not last for long and wish that it would never happen again to anybody. The duration of stay is usually regarded as temporary, but nevertheless, for some of it lasts for tens of years already, and for the others it lasts for the whole life. In my today contribution, I will introduce to you...
Can you wait, please, because the microphones don't work.
Okay. I have a game. So I begin from the beginning. Here I'm again, Vesna C from Slovenia, freelance photographer working in art, humanitarian education and research projects in the fields of photography, video, graphic prints, etc. First of all, I want to thank to both juries, In Transition Russia International Festival jury and In Transition International Conference jury to select my photo project to be shown at the traveling exhibition, as well as to have opportunity to advocate my work as an example of field practice here before this audience as well. I take both names of events very seriously and literally, and I would like to share my working experience with and for refugees with you. After any military intervention, refugees usually first live in tents, then are moved to desolated houses situated in the suburbs of the cities. Sometimes they get a big room, but without a window, no drainage system is functioning properly, without electricity to use the technical devices. And by it, they are keeping the old productive system alive. Anyway, for people in need, this is the only way to survive. All these are everybody companions of every refugee's existence all around the globe. All of the refugees believe that such a situation would not last for long, and wish that it would never happen again to anybody. The duration of stay is usually regarded as temporary, nevertheless, for some of it lasts for tens of years already, and for others it lasts for their whole life. In my today's contribution, I will introduce to you my past and ongoing activities on photo documentation for social change we are running now with Azerbaijan and foreign volunteers in Baku. From history, we know that in all regions between Black and Caspian Sea, fighting for country borders resulted in various permanent and strong migrations. What used to be once southern are today's northern borders, and there are problems to specify what belongs to whom and why. As a consequence of the politics of the region, and as a result of various military interventions, today capital of Republic Azerbaijan, Baku, has 3 million of inhabitants, and among them there are 1 million of refugees from home and abroad. All of them are trying to find their way out from their refugee status and want to integrate into everyday life and adapt themselves to change political conditions of post-socialist transition for better or for worse. This is our actuality. My photo documentation work in Baku is based on the field work with refugees and volunteers from different countries or organizations, all aiming to help these located groups to bridge the abyss of the destruction and jump on the other side, forgetting the horrors in the past and enter permanently new situation we are all living in. The dislocated groups have few possibilities to stay in a host city or country, to go further away from homeland, or if possible, to reach home again. I myself am from the country of recent transition from socialism to Western type of democracy. In my own country, I already have worked with the refugees and have experiences how to deal with problems and solve them by means of photo documentation. I presented my photo and video archive with activities on refugee issue, which was taken in Slovene refugee centers during and after the Balkan War in between 1995 and 2003, to volunteers from Association of Young Azerbaijan Friends of Europe. Thanks to ASIF, cooperation and help of European Voluntary Service volunteers, Tina from Finland and Ivan from Italy, we agreed to visit one of the refugee quarters in Baku and implement the method of photo documentation for the benefit of refugees. On our first visit to refugee center in Darnagal, nobody seemed to be interested in us but children. They waited for us at the door side of the family with the youngest refugee in the quarter, 2 months old baby. The children wanted to be on every photo we took, and soon we became a common group, sticking our noses to everything visible. They showed us the school, a yard, a shop, and a restaurant. There were more and more new children coming to the yard, and they all wanted to be photographed alone or with their friends. We met bakers from Baku while returning hungry from the refugee center in refugee quarter Darnagal on the outskirts of Baku. This quarter is situated near the White Soviet Avenue, still named after Karl Marx, where refugees are living in old apartments. Entering the bakery to buy some sweets was like going back in history where working class was beginning to form. So the Foucault thesis about the history of madness, about certain locations holding the social energies throughout changing ideologies, is argued once more. The bakery was a preservation of traditional bread baking and is still practicing, as is still practicing in Caucasus villages. The stoves were adapted to urban conditions. The traditional fire made out of wood was replaced by tambours filled by gas, which can be found in abundance in the Caspian area. The atmosphere in the bakery was exactly as I stigmatically imagined Soviet working class women years ago, working in the hard conditions, full of energy with a real force to gain better life. I asked the bakers if I could take some photos. The bakers accepted the idea enthusiastically, and with their help, the photo project Bakers from Baku came to life. On my next visit, on my next visit to Baku in 2007 with Bilura, she was volunteering Ayafe, we visited bakers again to give them my, so-called my, but they are their photos. They told me that they are the refugees for Nagorno-Karabakh region, earning their daily life by baking bread. The Bakers from Baku series is dedicated to them and their optimism, and as well to all of you who will see them. In 2008, after finishing the conference here in Ekaterinburg, I will return to Baku, not only for taking photos, but for running a seminar on photo documentation for photographers, international relations and art students, for social workers, volunteers and others interested. The aim, cooperating with organizations that are taking care of war and post-war situations, especially with those hosting volunteers that work on diminishing everyday monotony of life for all of those in exile. For them, the need for help is obvious, and volunteers from home and abroad are daily sacrificing themselves to help people in need. Therefore, strong methods are necessary to support their work and practice. The volunteers are usually young, therefore they need help to be able to give help. Documentary photography is a good practice to support their work. Why? Let's start with Lazarus' question. I quote, do we have the right to use unknown people's lives as a means of investigating the artistic styles or for satisfying our own inquisitiveness without penetrating deeper the meaning of that which connects us to those people? End of quote. We could find the answer to this question in photographer Gordon Park's statement from a few years earlier. I quote, in the course of time, I learned that it is not enough to watch, condemn, or praise to be just an observer. I must transcend the limit of my own experience by deeply sharing the problems of those I take pictures of. We must stop silently watching and start performing our duties in praxis. End of quotation. Only such photo documentation could imprint into photography that impulse which will take along also personal and social change. And also, whom is documentary photography for? The photo documentation is for all of those who need change, see the need for change, and for all of those who can enable change to happen. The main point in my photo project for social change is breaking the monotony of everyday life in refugee camps and centers by means of education, solve the everyday problems of refugees, and advocating the needs for means of publicity. My photo project Bakers from Baku was supported by now by volunteers from Azerbaijan, from Association of Young Azerbaijan Friends of Europe, Bakers from the Bakery Hleb in Baku, Ministry Republic Slovenia of Culture, Ministry Republic Slovenia of Foreign Affairs, European Cultural Foundation, Open Society Institute, Budapest, Ministry Republic Azerbaijan of Youth and Sports, Association Months of Photography, Slovene Ethnographic Museum, Municipality of Ljubljana, and Embassy of Russian Federation in Ljubljana, who were kind enough to offer me a visa free of charge. Thanks to all of them, and thanks to you. Thank you.